Hello, and welcome to Advanced macOS Onboarding Workflows. Before we get started, I just need to show a little forward-looking statement disclaimer that you'll also receive a copy of this beforehand, but I'm just going to pause for a minute so you may review it. Okay, so today we have joining us is Matt Wilson, one of our senior solution architects from Insight, and myself, Joshua Rood, a pre-sale systems engineer for the Apple product team within Insight. And we both support Jamf and the Apple product line. So a little bit of an agenda today will be Insight's Mac enablement program. Just going to give a little overview of that. Then we're going to go into enablement workflow build-out with using the Mac IBM enrollment app. We were going to have a little demo video for you to play in here, but due to technical difficulties, we do not have the demo video, but we will be uploading the video to a repository for you to download and view later, and we'll share that link at the end when we get into our final remarks. Before we jump into advanced macOS onboarding workflows, we wanted to highlight Insight's Mac enablement program designed to overcome roadblocks to Mac adoption within an organization. Insight holds a unique position based on our offerings. We design ourselves as a super solutions integrator, meaning we are equipped to deliver meaningful change at speed and at a greater return on an investment at scale. The Mac enablement program is a comprehensive services solution consisting of a unique and powerful combination of professional services and managed services. These five items listed are our program's core items, with advanced onboarding as one part of our Mac enablement services offering. So let's start with why. Why do we want to build an advanced onboarding experience for macOS? Here are some of the reasons to answer that why question: to allow more choice and empowerment for the end users, create a better user-friendly onboarding experience, provide information to users that IT feels they might need, and free up IT resources to research and create additional excellent resources for users. And plus, there's more smiles per gallon. And our little happy face did not transfer, so that's why we say smiles. And let's face it, I'm going to pause for a slight impact. And it's amazing. So with that, I'm going to hand over the next section to Matt Wilson, an Insight Senior Solutions Architect, to go over how Insight creates advanced onboarding workflows.
Hey, thank you for that, Josh. So how do we go about building this amazing onboarding experience? So we're going to walk through some of the steps around how we build out the enrollment application, and take a look. So first off, here we have our requirements. You will need an Apple developer cert. It is possible to use a self-signed cert to sign the application for testing. But in order to deploy the app from Jamf as a proper developer application is needed. Of course, we'll need the enrollment application itself, and then just a little bit of time. And the reason there's an asterisk next to that is because depending on your familiarity with Xcode, modifying code itself, and how extensive you want to modify the enrollment application, it may take some additional time there. All right. So in order to get the application, this is probably one of the easier steps in the process. You go out to GitHub and download that repository. We will have a link to the repo there at the end of our keynote. And then you'll want to go ahead and launch that Xcode project and get it open up in Xcode. The next step here, some of the things we can modify are the application name itself. This can be anything you want. We can add image icons for the actual application icon. You can upload and add apps that are going to be installed. You can add those icons like Word, PowerPoint, Excel, Microsoft Teams, Snagit, Google Chrome, Firefox, what have you. The text and labels throughout the application are completely customizable. For example, on this the bundle payload window, you can do various payload types here. So for this example, we have a connectivity bundle, an essentials bundle, and a productivity bundle. And what those do is essentially describe what the end user is going to receive on their Mac once they select those bundle types. For example, the connectivity bundle, it may just have, you know, what you want the end user, like the basics, maybe Outlook and Teams, so they can get up and running as quickly as possible. This will be the fastest way to get the user up and running, you know, 5 minutes or less. And then they can get everything else they need through self-service. The other two bundle types just kind of build upon that. Maybe the next level up, you get WebEx or Snagit or some other common tools used by employees at your organization. And the last one there, I like to just add the Office Suite there just because it takes the longest. And I know for me, I don't want to sit there and wait for my Mac to enroll for, you know, 25, 30 minutes because I'm waiting on Office to install. And then you can actually adjust the application bundle lists in the enrollment application if you want to change the number of apps that are installed during enrollment, or at least that show up in the application during enrollment. And then as far as views and navigations, we can modify various portions. And I like this one in particular, the registration window, because you can actually pull in the name of the user that's enrolling. You can capture other information about that end user, maybe the location where they're enrolling from, like region, maybe the department that they're working with, maybe some other information about that device, if it's going to be a testing device, things of this nature. And those items can actually be stored locally. And pulled into Jamf later and update the user record and the computer record and things of that nature. And you notice here, in this example, we actually removed the cancel buttons and the skip buttons in each window because we actually want the user to move through the enrollment process. Almost, you know, because we don't want to... Essentially, we don't want the user to have to quit out of the application because the default behavior would actually be to remove the MDM framework and unenroll the device if they choose to cancel. Since we don't want them to do that, we actually remove that functionality from the app. And once we're done modifying and setting up the app the way we want it to look and feel for our end user, the enrollment experience, we then begin the build process. And the first item there in the build process is signing each of the products. You have your actual the application itself that you want to sign with that developer cert. There is the helper tool, the privileges helper tool that needs to be signed, and also the launch daemon needs to be signed as well. And then next we build out the debug payload here, and that's just to ensure that everything loads properly and all the errors are corrected and things of that nature if there are any. And then we go about building or modifying the privilege helper so that the enrollment application can communicate to the Jamf binary when we need to make calls to it so that we can install packages and applications and policies and things of that nature during the enrollment process. And finally, we actually build and archive the app bundle that we're going to use as a part of the package that gets uploaded into Jamf. As far as deployment goes, you want to create your deployment package. And for this example, I actually used the packages application just because it's what I'm most familiar with. I like the way it's laid out. But in this package, you want to add the application itself into the applications folder you see there. You'll add the privileges helper the privilege helper into the privilege helper folder within the system library, or the root library, sorry. And then you'll add the launch daemon that's provided along with the GitHub repository. And then you move over to the scripts tab, which is up there at the top, and you'll actually add the post-installation script that's included. And then next you'll, also don't want to forget what you call out. You want to sign your package with that developer cert, because we want to use this as a enrollment package in Jamf. Then next you'll actually upload that package into Jamf. Similar, they're exactly the same way that you would for, you know, any other package in Jamf. And then we'll create three different policies depending on how you want the workflow to function. There's an enrollment script that actually, in this example, will be set the policy to run at an enrollment completion, and that will download the application and get that enrollment process started for the end user. They'll see the welcome screen on the enrollment app, and they'll start to walk through some of those registration pages or windows, some of the bundle windows, and be able to see which apps are going to be installed, things of that nature. There's a download speed policy that will add, or a script that will add in a policy in Jamf. And that actually runs just before the enrollment application is launched. And that essentially downloads a dummy package from Jamf to kind of get a baseline of the speed, depending on the network where the user's at. That way we can give the user kind of an estimated time that they'll need for each app bundle. Again, each bundle builds on itself. So if they select the first, that connectivity bundle, and maybe the productivity bundle, it'll aggregate, it'll combine those times so that the user knows how long they need to have the Mac there waiting for it to be configured and set up. And then finally, there's an app bundle installation script. So once the users select the bundles they need, we can make the proper calls out to Jamf to install those, or to the Jamf binary, sorry, to install those application bundles. Let's see. Oh, yep. And you can see this is pretty fairly extensive process to set up, depending on what you want to do. But it really does provide a really good end user experience. You know, it gives the end user the ability to choose kind of how they want their Mac to look and feel, but also gives, you know, IT management the ability to control or tailor the end user experience. So it's kind of the best of both worlds there. And with that, I will pass it back to Josh.
Thanks, Matt. Yeah. So with Insight's proven methodology, we know that Apple's platform is even better with Jamf and partners like Insight helping you. Insight's amazing capabilities make us Jamf and Apple's leading channel partner for services and solutions. No other partner can help Jamf customers scale like we can, ensuring customers realize Apple platform's potential by assisting them to get there faster with the accelerated capabilities through our managed service offerings and our global footprint. So, some resources. Using the following QR codes, you can download additional resources information. So, for example, if you need the Mac IBM enrollment repo, that QR code will take you to that. Our demo repo, where we'll have a demo version of this app, and the demo video that we could not get uploaded into the presentation will be there as well, so you could see how we are using this app internally. And then if you would like more information about our Mac enablement program, the QR code there will take you to that information. So with that, I'd like to thank you for joining us today, and we hope you're enjoying this year's virtual JNUC 2020. Thank you.
Thanks, everybody.